Hi, I'm Patti Glad. I'm 24 years old and I am a semi-professional costumer, cosplayer, and costume designer. I've been sewing since I was 9, I think, so about 15 years. Costuming professionally for the past 2 years or so in the theater, and cosplaying for 9 years? Competitively cosplaying for the past 7. The first time I remember really caring about sewing. I grew up with a mom who was a very active seamstress, but we did not get along super well, and especially when she was trying to teach me things, she tried several times and it always ended up in big yelling fights and tears and hair pulling, and we just, did not do that. But then my best friend at the time, her mom taught sewing lessons out of her house, and I really, really, really wanted to do it. And I remember saving my allowance for months on end so that I could go and take sewing lessons from her. I'm a competitive cosplayer, which means like when I go to conventions, I both take costumes and run around in the halls. I go to panels. I shop and do things in my costumes, and I always love to get pictures taken with me, and that's always really fun. But I also do a lot of, I enter the masquerade contest and pretty much almost every convention I go to these days. And, my very first award was at that first convention, second convention, the Anime Banzai, where my friends and I dressed up as Sailor Moon and went on stage, and it was something cheesy and ridiculous, and we ended up winning second place overall. And it just, when they announced our names, like, it was just dead silent for about 3 seconds before we figured out that, wait, that was us. We did that. What? Yes, that's me. Okay. And just the rush of endorphins that I felt at that moment, like, that's really what keeps me going. I really love the detail work process. I love beadwork. I love hand embroidery, all the tedious stuff. Like, my most complicated costume, which is the sateen costume from Moulin Rouge, I believe there is 250 hours of work on that thing. There's more than $300 of Swarovski crystals on the corset because priorities. And they were tediously hand glued on one at a time over a corset shell made out of actually sequined pillowcases. All of the fringe on it is hand beaded, all of the decorations on the lapels and the edges, that's all hand done. Just very tedious handwork. So I tend to pick costumes that have a lot of that kind of stupid nitinoid detail, just so I can, pick it and say, look, I did this thing. Look at how many hours I spent on that. Please tell me you like me. Isn't it pretty? Kind of a thing. As far as the future for my costuming, for right now, one of my short-term goals is definitely I want to win a competition. I'm really proud of what I've done so far, but I've never won a best in show and I want one. And then at that point, I'm not quite sure how long I'll continue competing, but I really want to transition full-time into theatrical costuming. I've gained a lot of things from cosplay and costuming over the years. I mean, obviously one of the biggest ones is my costuming abilities. Like, there's no way I would be where I am professionally without having wanted to cosplay when I was really young. Obviously, I've gained a lot of confidence in myself as a cosplayer, but that same confidence carries over into the rest of my life and makes me a much better, more rounded person and someone who's a lot less afraid of other people, if that makes sense. I've always been pretty reserved and quiet, and when I was younger, I would definitely call myself shy, but I don't think of myself that way anymore, at least mostly because of what cosplay has done for me.